Good day, students. Today we will discuss about rectangular coordinate system. Okay, what does rectangular coordinate system means? Okay, but before we will deepen our understanding about this discussion, we need first to know and understand our learning objective for this day. Okay, we have here our learning objective. At the end of this discussion, you need to plot the given pair of coordinates in a Cartesian plane. So we are hoping that at the end of this discussion, you will be able to plot the given pair of coordinates in a Cartesian plane. Okay, so let's start discussing about rectangular coordinate system. Okay, so we have here vocabulary words that we may encounter during our discussion in rectangular coordinate system. So the first one, a rectangular coordinate system. So what does it mean? Okay, when we say rectangular coordinate system, it is a system for graphing number pairs. It is also called Cartesian coordinate system. So it is named after René Descartes. Okay, so who is René Descartes? By the way, so René Descartes is the founder of rectangular coordinate system. Okay, so okay, next one, to build the system, begin with a number line. Okay, we will begin a number line. So ano ba tong number line na to? So the example of a number line is this one, this line. Okay, this line. So it is a number line. So we will draw down a number line. And next one, and then draw, okay, take note, we will draw another number line, perpendicular. So what does it mean by perpendicular? Ibig sabihin, ganito yung gagawin natin. So we will draw another number line, which is dapat naka-perpendicular siya to the first so that their zero parts coincide. So what does it mean? Dapat daw naka-perpendicular para yung zero part nila dito banda, yung zero part, okay, wait for a while. Yung zero part nila is mag-coincide. Dito na part. Zero part. So, dapat daw, we will draw another number line which is naka-perpendicular sa first number line. This one, the first number line. Okay, gets ba? Okay, very good. So, let's proceed to the next one. Okay? So, the horizontal line, okay, take note. The horizontal line daw class, okay, this one is called x-axis. Okay, again, the horizontal line is called x-axis. The vertical line is called y-axis. When they are together, pag together daw sila, ibig sabihin, they are called coordinate axis. Okay, again, the horizontal line is called x-axis. The vertical line is called y-axis. When they are together, okay, pag together daw, they are called coordinate axis. Okay, gets ba? Okay, very good. So, in the given image or figure, this number line is called the x-axis. This one class, itong number line na to. So, ito yung x-axis, yung horizontal line. Okay, next one we have here, this number line is called y-axis. Okay, y-axis, this one, this is the y-axis or the vertical line. Okay, gets ba? Okay, very good. So next one, let's now proceed to this one, the point of intersection of the coordinate axis. This one, this x-axis and y-axis, the point of intersection daw is what we called origin, this red one, kung saan nag-coincide yung point or zero part ng x-axis at saka y-axis. So, ang tawag daw is origin or the point of intersection. So, kung saan yung point of intersection, ang tawag daw niyan is origin. Ang tawag is origin. Very good. Okay, next one, we have here, the axis divide the coordinate plane into four quadrants. So, this one, the y-axis and the x-axis, they divided the coordinate plane into four quadrants. So, we have here, these are labeled counterclockwise. So, we have here, quadrant 1, next one, quadrant 2, quadrant 3, and quadrant 4. So, they have signs of the coordinates of a point. So, yung sign of the ordered pair, okay, ordered pair siya. We have here, in the first quadrant, we have here positive and positive. Okay, next one for the second quadrant, we have here a negative, okay, negative and positive. For the third quadrant, we have here a negative and negative. And for the fourth quadrant, we have here positive and negative. So, ibig sabihin, class, when we say sa first quadrant daw, okay, ibig sabihin, this is the x-axis and the y-axis. So, ibig sabihin, positive si x, dito si 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, x-axis yan. And next one, si y is positive. So, yung up na y is positive and yung down na y is negative. And yung right na x is positive and yung left na x axis is negative. So, these are the signs of the coordinates of a point, okay? So, plotting a point, okay? We need to plot a point, okay? So, every point in the coordinate plane can be described by an ordered pair, the xy of values, okay? So, we have here x-axis or abscissa. Okay, the first number in the pair. So, yung x-axis daw is the first number in the pair. So, for example, you are given an ordered pair, 2 and 1. So, yung 2 daw, this 2 here, okay, erase muna natin. Okay, so yung 2 daw dito, class, okay, wait for a while. Yung 2 daw dito is the x-axis or abscissa. So, ibig sabihin siya yung first coordinate, okay? Si x-axis or abscissa. Next one, we have here y-coordinate or ordinate. So, the second number in the pair. For example, you are given an ordered pair, 2 and 1. 1 is the y-coordinate or ordinate. So, ibig sabihin si 1 is yung y-coordinate. And si 2 is our x-axis or abscissa. Okay, is it clear? Okay, very good. Okay, so we are done discussing the vocabulary words about rectangular coordinate system. So now let's proceed to plotting a pair of coordinates in a Cartesian plane. Okay, so we are going to plot an ordered pair in the given Cartesian plane. So for example, number one, okay, you are asked to plot the following. Okay, again, in a given ordered pair, so the x here or the first here is the x-axis or the abscissa. And the y here is the y-coordinate or the ordinate. So, ibig sabihin, si 3 is the x-axis and si 4 is the y-axis. Okay, so what are you going to do first is to create a Cartesian plane. Okay, Teacher Kim, ano ba yung magiging basihan namin kung ilang numbers na ilalagay namin sa number line? Okay, saan ba kami hihinto? Okay, so as you observe, class, you are given three ordered pairs. So we have here A, the 3 and 4, B, negative 1 and 4, and letter C, 4 and negative 2. So what are you going to do is to observe sino yung pinakamalaki na number sa kanila. So doon tayo hihinto. So ibig sabihin, since si 4 yung pinakamalaki sa kanila, therefore 4 lahat or sa 4 tayo hihinto. So we will create a number line. Okay, so we will first create y-axis. Okay, so we will first create y-axis. Okay, so lagay natin arrow. Next one, we will create x-axis. Okay, so we need to use a ruler in order for our Cartesian plane or rectangular coordinate system na magmukhang maganda at saka madaling maintindihan ng magbabasa nito. Okay, so ibig sabihin, each number line here, the positive x and the negative x, the positive y and the negative y, ibig sabihin 4 lang ang ating or sa 4 lang tayo hinto. Ibig sabihin, we have here 1. Okay, so we will get another pen. Okay, we have here 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we will label here positive 1, 2, 3, and 4.
So after that one, the next, okay, the negative side, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and negative 4. So ibig sabihin, we will label this one as negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and negative 4. So after that one class, another na naman dito sa y-axis. Therefore, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and negative 4. Next one, positive 1 rather, positive 2, positive 3, and positive 4. So label natin, we have here negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and negative 4. Okay, gets ba? Okay, very good. So here, we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So after that one class, is we are going to plot the given pairs. So let's start with letter A. So we have here letter A, C, X, and Y. Okay, so X is positive 3 daw. So therefore, dito tayo sa kay 3. And si Y daw class is si 4. So therefore, positive 4. Therefore, start kay 3, we will count 4. So start kay 3, we have here 1, 2, 3, and 4. So ibig sabihin class, dito tayo magpa-plot kay A. So, ibig sabihin, we have here 3 and 4. So, ibig sabihin, si X is our 3. Okay, yung nasa kanya. So, 3. Si 4 yung Y. Again, dito tayo magpa-plot. Okay, i-plot natin for a while. Okay, so we have here the plot. Okay, or the dot. Okay, we have here 3 yung X and 4 yung Y. Okay? So, next one. Okay, erase na natin yung line. Okay? So, na-plot na natin si A. Let's now proceed to letter B. Okay? Sino ba yung B? We have here our X, si negative 1. Okay? Our X is negative 1. And our Y is positive 4. Therefore, pupunta tayo kay positive 4 galing kay negative 1. So, starting kay negative 1, we will count 4. So, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Ibig sabihin, dito natin ilalagay ang dot or ang point. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, class, our B is here in the area. So, we have here our X, negative 1, and our Y is positive 4. So, this is our B. Okay, lagay natin. B. We have here negative 1 at saka si positive 4. Okay, copy ba? Okay, very good. So now let's proceed to letter C. So we have here positive X at saka negative 2 si Y. So positive 4 daw class. Okay, positive 4 daw si X. Tapos negative 2 si Y. Ibig sabihin sa baba tayo kay Y. Okay, again, this is our X and this is our Y. Okay, so starting kay 4, bababa tayo ng pangalawa. So starting kay 4, we have here 1 and 2. So ibig sabihin, dito natin ilagay si C, which is si 4 and negative 2. Therefore, class, ang X-axis ni point here is 4. Okay, 4. And the Y-axis is negative 2. So if you are asked to plot a pair of coordinates in a Cartesian plane, this A, B, and C, ibig sabihin, ito yung magiging answer ninyo. So, you are only going to plot. It is very easy. It's because you are only going to locate kung saan siya banda. Okay? So, you will only follow kung sino yung pinakamalaki. Ibig sabihin, doon kayo mag-stop. So, therefore, 4 yung malaki. So, therefore, 4 yung lahat dito. So, we will only follow kung sino yung X and kung sino yung 4. So, for example, kay letter A, so since 3 si X and 4 si Y, ibig sabihin dito, ipa-plot si A, or the ordered pair 3 and 4. Okay, is it clear? Okay, very good.